idol na era siya noong August 12. Ang part 1 to part 3 po niyan sa YouTube ay may title na Pakistani hinuthutan daw ng 3.5 million ang kanyang ex-girlfriend niyang Pinay.
Andito na si Muhammad and itong si ex niya na si Rose Corazon, pinamasaya natin.
Yes po.
All the way from Cagayan de Oro. And maging si Muhammad kasi ang flight niyo dapat today, nirebook natin yung kanyang ticket. Sinagot na natin and we promise him additional mga tulong kung kinakailangan hanggang sa sila ay makapag-ayos ni Rose. Kung hindi man, kung siya magdidemanda, din tutulungan natin siya makapag-demanda kung ano man mapag-usapan nila ngayon. Andito rin kasi si Rose. Pero bago kay Rose, kausapin natin muna itong si Mr. Muhammad. Mr. Muhammad, so how are you?
I'm good, sir.
Pasukin natin si Miss Rose Corazon Mataa. Paminsan-minsan, tulungan mo ako ha. Baka maubusan ako ng English dito. Wow naman. Ganda pala nito. Pwede pang oxy-white to eh, no? Ma'am Rose, ladies first. When was the last time you and Mr. Muhammad saw each other?
Barangay po namin na nagpatawag po siya. Naka-receive po ako ng letter from the barangay. Pumunta po ako sa barangay that time, yung date na po na nilagay po nila. Napag-usapan po namin po doon na kung ano po talaga yung reason niya, bakit po siya nag-complain sa akin. Kasi nung time na nagpadala po ng letter sa akin is wala ako sa bahay. So yung sister ko lang po yung naka-receive.
Okay.
So, ito po yung letter na na-receive ko from...
So, you received a subpoena from the barangay?
The barangay, yes.
What happened with that meeting, sir?
Actually, at that moment, whatever the concern she has, she said, let's see at the end. She said, we will see in the court.
Were you able to come up with a certain agreement?
No, actually, that time it was the amount about only about the annulment.
Okay, was it settled?
No, because at that moment she refused to pay that one and then she said that let's see in the court.
Okay. You've been mentioning to us 3.5 million pesos.
Yeah.
Right. And I would like to make it clear to everybody that you've been saying all along 3.5, but there were times that you said you only need 300,000 pesos money back from her.
Yeah.
Now, can I have a breakdown of that 3.5 million? How did it become 3.5? That minus the 300, because you said the 300 that you can justify by way of expenses and then the money that you gave her. How about the 3.2?
That is the overall expenses for the accommodation, traveling, food, sending money to her family, all included.
Also, you have receipts for those times that you sent money to her family.
I cannot keep the whole receipts with me because that all the receipts, the daily expenses, that what we have done is done by my credit card. And then she knows better also how
okay,
much
but, money. But still, if it was done through the credit card, then you would have received from the credit card company. To show that, in fact, you made charges or even incurred cash advances from your credit card. And at that time, you said you sent money to her family, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How much money have you sent to her and her family?
That total amount, I haven't count here, but I have the original receipt. In these receipts, you can consider the very first year. That receipt is only from one exchange.
But okay.
But we have sent through the different exchanges.
In short, the 3.2 million, this is just a calculation.
Yeah.
Of the total amount that total you amount. Have given her.
Yeah, approximately.
Including,
amounts.
You know, sending money to her family.
Yes, sir.
Gusto ko pong malaman lang po ng lahat na hindi po ako scammer at hindi rin po ako swindler, hindi rin din po ako gold digger. Kasi nung nandun po ako sa Dubai, wala po akong trabaho nun kasi tourist po ako. Pero hindi ka makakapasok ng Dubai nang hindi ka fully prepared na wala kang pera, mag-i-stay ka ng 3 buwan. So means, meron akong pera, galing pa lang ako ng Pinas, so hindi ako manghihingi ng pera ng kahit kanino dahil nga, di ba sinabi ko na may trabaho ako nung nasa Pinas pa lang ako. At dun pa lang sa Singapore, hindi ka makakapunta ng Dubai pag hindi ka nagpre-present ng bank statement. So which is, meron akong pera. Kung magpapabili man ako, eh meron naman akong pera. Bakit naman ako manghihingi sa kanya? Voluntary niya yung binigay. Kasi nakita niya yung sitwasyon ko na wala nga akong blanket. Kasi hindi ko naman iniisip na mag-i-stay ako forever para sa Dubai. Doon lang ako for 3 months. So, hindi ako nag-expect na bumili ng mga gamit na marami para mag-stay. Did I request to you, did
expenses?
I told you to buy me our grocery and everything?
Yes, that's,
did I?
That's what I have
from
the print.
From my mouth? Are you sure, Arshad?
Yes, I have
the
screenshot here. Yes.
Are you sure?
Here is, I will show it to you.
What I have remember is you told me, let's go to Sahara, let's buy blanket and everything because I saw that you don't have anything in my room.
Mr. Muhammad, did she or did she not ask for blankets and groceries?
She asked. She asked for
money from you.
Personal hygiene, personal these things.
Really, yeah?
There is the message, I can give it to you.
Kasi ang iniisip ko lang po, kung sinasabi niya na nagpapabili ako, syempre kung manliligaw ka sa isang babae, lahat gagawin mo. Magpapa-impress ka. So ginawa niya yon. Pero yung sinasabi mo na ako magpapabili ng blanket tapos may pera ako, para imposible naman yata yon.
I don't see anything wrong if you guys are into a relationship.
Yes, exactly.
That you will be asking money from him.
Exactly.
And him voluntarily giving money to you. It only becomes a problem if you really don't have intention of making that relationship become serious to the point that he was expecting that you guys eventually will get married.
Yeah.
That's why he kept on giving you money time and time and time again until he said, go ahead, file an annulment case against your husband and I will finance that.
Sure.
And he was expecting that after annulment case will materialize, then you guys will get married. Doon po nagkaroon ng problema. Kasi tanggap ng pera sa kanya, yung pala, wala ka talagang balak, napakasalan siya. At ang punteriya mo lang talaga is pag nakuha ko na yung pera sa kanya at nakapag-anal na ako, then magbubuhay dalaga na ako.
Like other partner or couple. For the first time, we already talk about marriage. Eager siya to annul my marriage.
And what you have said, that rather than I waste my money, I will wait for my husband to die. Is that correct? Did you say that?
But
because you don't have the money to spend on that.
Then regarding also, he said that my family is asking for money. Let me read it. From Arshline, I did always in million ways. It's just I never tell anything from mouth. You pay them, I will give it to you. You get from the bank, I will send it to you. It's my treat for your family.
So but, you're referring to the last Christmas, the one last time I was there.
It's not about that, Ashlan.
Okay.
So you are telling
was,
to everybody as
amount,
well that I'm
amount,
asking a money for
amount,
you or spending for the food
we,
and everything. This
talking,
is already evidence,
Ashlan. 4,000 to 5,000 for one dinner.
4,000 pesos for a dinner?
Yeah, for the one night.
In pesos?
In the pesos.
Who asked that you guys go to dinner?
There was some kind of occasion that like Christmas.
Okay.
That's money she did not ask. I told her, okay, you can take a dinner with your family. I'll be the one will treat you for that dinner. So I will pay you for that. You can take right now because that is the same
okay.
day. So I cannot send it to you right now. So you can take from your account. This is she's referring to this December only. I believe that is a message from this December, not previously. We are talking about annulment before procedure and after
but you're
the annulment.
Also talking about I'm a gold digger. I'm asking
yes.
for money from
why
you.
Why I told you gold digger? Because you have given me false hope and everything. You are stating that you are
false
going to
hope?
Get.
False hope? Let me to show them. We don't have like promises. We only have like some other couple that planning for a marriage. Because from my part, I'm not very eager to make a marriage. Because for that 14 years, that is a waste of money, time and effort. Regarding with the marriage, I got already the PSA.
Who spent for your annulment case?
Me.
Your was it your money or his
my
money?
My money.
This money was gone.
The
to
arrangements
hold.
Was like this.
How much money was spent? You spent
actually,
for your annulment case.
My attorney told me already.
How much?
For that only 60.
60,000 pesos.
Yes.
Okay.
And then it so happened there is a lot of expenses that I let my attorney.
So where did it come from?
From my BPI account.
So ibig sabihin, pera niyo po yon. Sa account nyo. Hindi yung binigay niyang pera sa inyo at inilagay mo sa banko
nyo. And when
nyo.
I was in Dubai, okay. here, even if I'm in Dubai, I'm still paying for it.
Okay.
And also the conversation was there.
What was the date?
May 5, 2017. Let
so
me read
started,
this one. Good morning, Attorney Joel. Thank you so much. Can you please send me the copy for the true email or picture regarding my payment? If possible, I will pay you next month. I got my check, but I cannot clear because I don't have visa and Dubai bank account. So hopefully by next
okay.
month.
Ang bottom line talaga rito, he was expecting na kayo po eventually ay kakasal. Dahil yun po yung pagkakaalam niyang mangyari base po sa mga napag-uusapan niyo habang kayo po magkarelasyon pa. At kaya nga po siya bigay ng pera sa inyo. Kahit na hindi niyo po hinihingi. Sabi ko nga, there's nothing wrong with that. Him giving you money, kung ano pa yung mga gift na yon. Kaya lang po ma'am, nabanggit niya, you gave him false hope. He was hoping na ikakasal kayo. Kaya nga po, nagbigay doon siya ng pera para sa annulment na dinidinay mo naman. At nung nag-materialize na po yung annulment ninyo, nung yung ex-husband, then sinabi mo sa kanya, ay, ayoko na magpakasal kasi gusto ko lang maging buhay dalaga. Yun po talaga ang pinaka-problema rito. Kasi
okay.
kung wala ho yun, ma'am, wala sana siyang reklamo.
Hindi ko sinasabi na para magbubuhay ako ng dalaga.
That's
what I mean is, habang sinisettle ko po kasi ako pa rin po yung nagbabayad. Kahit nandun po ako sa Dubai, ako pa rin po yung nagbabayad.
Are you officially annulled at that time?
Yes.
Okay, so if your marriage was officially annulled at that time, then what stopped you from continuing having a relationship with him and then marrying him?
Yan na nga po. Ito na po yung pinaka miserable life na nangyari sa
miserable.
Akin sa Dubai. Yeah, miserable na nangyari po sa akin. Sa
Define Dubai. Miserable, ma'am, in your term.
Yeah. Which is yung time na po na nananakit siya sa akin.
Ano po yung mga ebidensya nyo?
Ito po yung mga blood clot po ng mga pasako na po na.
Oh, okay.
At umiiyak na po ako dahil wala po akong ibang mapupuntahan dahil yung parents ko nasa Manila. Dahil wala po akong malalapitan dahil ako lang po doon. Saka hindi naman po ako pwede na umalis dahil may kontrata pa po ako sa trabaho ko for 2 years.
Oo nga.
So yun lang po ang kinasasakit ko dahil...
Referring to your these messages, I just want to ask, physical abuse. You was telling about to the
this
people.
This is physically and mentally trauma for me, Arslan.
You give me much more than that. You give me much more than that because
you
I have given you every single thing what
Filipina
you have asked
will
for.
Say that we will get married with you if you
sandali,
are doing
sandali,
this
sandali.
Kind
sir,
of
sir,
thing.
Sir, I'm just being fair here, okay? Yeah. Please explain to me this process. Face, nose, cheek, shoulder, legs, thigh, different parts of her body.
Putting a chickenini in my neck.
Well, chickenini, no, that's not counted, ma'am.
Okay.
That's not physical abuse. So many bruises. Can you explain to me this?
So I want to ask one question to her in that one. If I have done that much to you in Dubai, you don't have anyone to give you a justice, to give only one time to call 999 and then you get the justice on that. If ever I have done this one to you,
Do you give me the reason to call them? Even I cannot get even medical. When I was going to my work, you will pick me and then drop me. How can I go where somewhere?
So that pick up and drop, it was to suffocate you or it was to look at you or it was for what purpose? It was just to give you comfort, to pick up you, to drop you, even you have the car lift.
And can you imagine you make a duplicate inside my flat so that you can go inside?
This thing we can check with the... with Dubai government
harassment
that
already
you stated in the last phone call you said
hold on ma'am yung parang siya magkaroon ng duplicate dahil kayo po magkarelasyon normal po yon. I don't see anything wrong
no,
with
sir,
that so so that he can go in and out of your plot because magkasintahan kayo
not sir I'm just renting for one person and many people is living there.
Females that you
yes,
mentioned last time.
Yes, that's female.
And
exactly.
If I am going to do this kind of things to make a duplicate key in UAE and I'm going to enter in your house, do you think it's not a big problem for me? How could I do that? And if ever I'm going to do, there is a CCTV camera, there is everything. How is it possible?
But that is a trespassing.
I'm very sensitive to physical abuse, especially
that's
to women.
That's what I'm asking.
Sir, can you explain to me? Really, I'm very, very super sensitive when it comes to physical abuse against women. Please explain to me again one more time. This one example, bruises, scratches on her shoulder.
This is not about me. You can prove that one is by me?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
During remember in the road, in the middle of the road of Dubai?
Okay.
You cannot see that one because I'm wearing of something cloth that you cannot see, but you're already here.
In the middle of the road, if I'm going to do anything wrong with the lady, do you think is that easy to do there?
Even inside of your friend's
house, any single person from UAE
house, you already insulted me and making a harassment to me.
So you're saying, sir, this is self-inflicted?
No, I'm going to deny on that.
So she did it to herself?
There is any other...
Or somebody must have done this to her?
Someone has done to her, or is there something else?
Okay.
I've never seen that personally. She never shown me this kind of things in before. We never happened this kind of thing.
You want me to ask Ate Mariam on that one? Because I'm the one sending messages every time you want you are doing something to me. I cannot ask anyone because I don't want to let my family knows about what's happening to me because my mother's stroke and everything. So I don't want to let them to know that I'm suffering there while I'm doing the things for me, for them, to support them.
Also, you stated in the last time that you was alone in Dubai. Nobody was there to look after you. That's why you was just scared over there.
Why did you not call the authorities when this happened to you? Why didn't you call 999?
Kasi nga po, tinatakot na po niya ako.
Na?
Like, kasi alam po natin na maraming Pilipina po na pinapatay ng Pakistan. Ayoko pong umuwi ng kabaong.
What?
Kasi gusto kong tulungan ang pamilya ko. Pumunta ako ng Dubai para magtrabaho. Hindi pumunta ng Dubai para makipagladian. Tapos uuwi ka ng kabaong.
So, natakot ka magsumbong. Sino po yung mga napagsabihan mo na kayo po yung sinasaktan?
Ang palagi ko po pinasasabihan na sinasaktan po ako, yung asawa po ng kaibigan niya. Tapos, every time na nagtitext po ako, every time po na inaano ko po, dinidelete ko po siya diretso kasi kinukuha niya po yung cellphone ko. Diba sabi niya nga, may mutual po kami, tapos nakikita niya lahat ng conversation. Kaya halos tinatago ko lahat. Mga ginagawa ko na magsisend ako ng message dahil hindi ko alam kung ano pa pong possible na pwede niya magawa sa akin.
Can we verify that? Yung sinasabi mo na pinagdadalhan mo ng mga messages na you're being harmed by this guy?
Yeah, you can talk to Ate Mariam, the wife of the friend of his wife.
About me, you have told to many of the people. You have made so many screenshots about me. Even during the relationship, you are good with me. But backside of mine, you are talking to the other friends of yours. I don't want to mention here right now, but I will show that things. You are talking so bad about me. At that moment, I never seen that things because I don't know your language and I cannot understand it. But now when I go to translate to somebody, they translated that kind of words.
Sino yan?
It's better if you should not disclose the privacy of other outside the mic. You can let them listen and they can explain to them.
The people knows what you are doing
ano
to me.
Yung...
But you are not going to use the name of the other people.
Ano po yan, record niya?
You used my son's name here. Even your friend's name, Wakas, you are also... So why
ano, ma'am, excuse me, anong sinasabi dyan sa video na
hindi
yan?
Hindi niya po ako titigilan. Kahit nga po nandito ako.
That is... worst enough for me.
Para gawin niya po ang lahat.
And mention the date.
Siguro dahil sinisingil ka niya, tapos hindi siya titigil hanggat hindi kanya masisingil. Baka yun yung ibig niya sabihin. Was he threatening you bodily harm?
Yeah.
Meron ho ba dyan? Ito pong gagawin natin. Ma'am.
Just let me know. I will try to arrange and then I will send it to you if you need it. But first thing you do is not to make too many expense. Yes, Pesi, I know how hard it is for you and also it is hard for me. But what to do, Pesi? If we are just keep trying, there is something that you don't want to understand. There is something I don't want to understand. So that's why we are just keeping trying.
And
spending the time. And I told you...
That's just a voice of a guy who's in love with you.
Myself. I want to
know he would
stable. And you want to get married. Anything. At least if I'm married
no
already,
promise of anything.
Even I do something or I will not do something.
Married.
My life is going in a one way. Not just waiting something.
Yes, waiting something because I have been that's what I mentioned 3 times we have spoke about that and then 3 times I taken the requirements for the marriage but you deny. That's why.
Willing ka ba makipag-ayos sa kanya? Yun ang reason ba't namin kayo pinadala rito na pag-ayosin kayong dalawa. You know, the reason why we ask her to come over, Mr. Muhammad, is to have you both talk to each other and both of you will agree to forget the past and then move on. And but, if there's any money that she needs to pay you, let's see if we can have her agree to pay you that money.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line here right now. So what is it that you want again one more time from her?
I want to get the money.
And how much money?
I want
money
to get the money. That is the same.
How much money are we
talking
about?
What I have mentioned.
200,000.
At first, I was agreed just to settle the things. I just told her in the bank.
Okay, 300,000. Ma'am, 300,000 pesos. And after that, wala na siyang pakialam sa iyo. Yun yung sinasabi niya kanina. Pati nung last time.
I will not give 300,000 for him. I will just file a case for you.
No problem. I will go with that.
Okay. So, hindi na natin maayos to.
I will not reconcile because with him, he destroyed already my
reputation. No, reconciliation is out of the question. And we're not gonna push for reconciliation here kasi nakikita po na yung takbo ng pag-uusap kanina pa, pati nung mga nakarang araw. Ang sa akin lang is, meron bang magko-compromise dito sa inyo na para magkaayos na kayo? Hindi sa kinakampiyan ko itong si ma'am, pero nakita ko may point siya na itong lalaki, nananakit talaga ito.
And there should be a justice for me.
The only thing is, sana at that time nung sinasaktan ka niya, you should have called the authorities. Now, sabi mo natatakot ka? Ba't ka natatakot?
Yun nga po, natatakot po ako sa ano pa kung possibly niyang magawa sa akin.
Kasi no, kasi when if you call the authorities, then makukulong siya. So, ba't hindi niyo po tinawagan yung 999?
Hindi po kasi ganun yun kadali kung nasa Dubai ka. Na sabihin mo na lang natatawag ka. Of course, there will be an investigate for that. And then, hindi ganun.
Ah, hindi ka agad ikukulong doon?
Oo.
Hindi ka tulad dito na pwede kang kalabusuhin pag nakita na meron kang pasa.
At saka, sinisecure ko lang po yung sarili ko dahil may instances na di po ba nabawal.
Ah, kasi tourist din kayo doon.
Yes. At ang Dubai po is bawal po yan sa yung sabihin natin na nagsasama. So,
bawal na nagsasama na?
Pero hindi po kami magkasama ng that time.
Bawal magkasama na
hindi mag-asawa.
Ah, okay. So yun ang isang dahilan kaya kumiwas na magsumbong. Mm-mm. Baka madiskubre, imbis na ikaw nagsusumbong, ikaw kasama sa kong siyami.
Opo. At tapos, yun po ang magiging dahilan na maging deportation ko.
Bawal sa Dubai ang mag-live-in.
Opo. At yun po din ang maging dahilan, baka ma-deport po ako. At gusto ko rin pong, dahil gusto kong maging malinis na nasa ibang bansa ako, ang reputasyon ko po.
Now, tell me the truth, ma'am. I'm gonna help you, if you were the one who's been aggrieved. Pinaasa mo ba siya o hindi?
Hindi ko po siya pinaasa. Kasi kung sasabihin natin pinaasa ko siya, sa simula pa lang po na, yung marriage po namin na, kasi minahal ko po siya actually. Minahal ko po siya, alam niya yan.
So, why did you change your mind?
Dahil nga po nga nananakit na po siya sa akin. At hindi ko na po makaya yung attitude niya na ganun na napipicture out ko po na darating yung panahon. Kasi nagkamali na po ako ng first sa marriage ko.
Ayoko ano nangyari sa first marriage doon?
Actually, yung husband ko naman po ang umalis sa bahay namin.
Okay.
So, ayoko na pong maulit at pinipicture out ko po na gusto ko na magkaroon ng magandang pamilya. So, yun po yung gusto ko na siya na ini-expect ko na magiging makasama ko habang buhay. Pero, nagkamali po pala ako na napinili.
Okay. During the times that he started hurting you, doing this physical abuse, bakit patuloy ka pa rin humingi ng pera sa kanya? Why did you continue on with the relationship and kept asking money from him?
Hindi po ako humingi ng pera sa kanya. Kasi mapapatunayan ko po yan na sa dalawang taon ko pong pagstay sa Dubai, nung hindi pa po ako tourist.
At that time that he was hurting you, doing your physical abuse, you could have just turned your back and said, stop it, I don't want you anymore. I don't want this relationship to continue. Fuck it. I'm gonna leave you now. Why did you do that?
Ginawa ko naman po yun. Yun nga po yung yun nga po yung pinakinig ko kanina na nagpunta pa nasa point po kami na nag-usap kami. Maganda yung pinag-usap.
So meron kang video niyan?
Yun nga po. Pinag-usap na. Yun na nga po yun eh. Bago siya nagpakasal, maganda na po yung usapan.
No. I'm talking about physical abuse kasi ma'am, I'm very super sensitive. Alam niyo yan. Alam ng lahat yan. Pag yung mga kababayan na sinasaktan, pini-physical abuse. Allergic po ako dyan. Ang point ko lang po, nung kayo po'y sinasaktan na, bakit hindi kayo tumalikod? Iniwanan nyo na siya? You said no. You could have said, ayoko na, I want to stop this relationship. You turn her back on him and you stop accepting money from him. Kasi ma'am, yung patuloy mo pa rin pagtatanggap ng pera sa kanya, kahit na kayo po'y nasaktan na, it just shows na meron po kayong balak na talagang perahan siya. Yun po ang lilitaw.
Hindi na po ako umaano sa kanya ng pera.
Kung baka tiniis mo na lang yung sakit, basta kapalit naman ito pera. Parang ganun po ang dating sa amin.
Hindi po. Wala, hindi na po.
Correct me if I'm wrong.
Hindi po ako nag-accept na ng pera sa kanya. Yung time na yan, nakahiwalay na po ako sa kanya. Ang ginagawa niya yan sa akin.
So, nung mangyari ito, umiwalay ka na sa kanya?
Oo, wala na nga ako. Wala na po ako. Ako mismo ang umalis sa plot na kung saan magkasama kami pero magka-separate kami ng partition.
All right, sir, I understand that you were...
At hindi pa siya married that time.
You were denying all these bruises.
Yeah.
That you were not the one who did this to her. But I'm gonna ask it anyway. After these happened, is it true that she turned her back on you and she left you?
First thing I want to ask her, is that you are mentioning is the one time or is a different time or what is that?
It's different. This one, when Parhan's home, right? Remember these clothes? Parhan's home, when his her girlfriend is
Who's
also Parham's? There.
Who's Parhan's?
His friend. House of his friend were there. Detalyado. When he's hurting me.
Detalyado si ma'am, kung ganon.
Yeah. And all that.
And this one?
This one.
Okay.
This one was in the road in Dubai, right?
Okay. So two.
Two. How about this one?
Actually, this is two in one.
Okay.
And one, okay, in one place. It's
okay,
the
so
same.
Two
from the.
How about this one? Is it the same?
This is the same.
Same.
The other one.
Okay, so twice.
And also from the last time was in Naim's home, his friend.
This one,
home.
Shoulder.
Yeah, this is the one.
So you are stating three times I have physically abused you. Is that correct?
Yeah.
So in that three times, you did not even get single time chance to call any authorities or to anyone or to do anything against me in UAE. You know that UAE is a safe.
How many times I already told you? Did you give me time for to call police and
How
everything?
How long time it
You know you are the
call?
One holding my mobile.
You are
everything.
Not,
you don't want me to go anywhere. Even you are just
one
putting
second.
Me in the room.
1 second, let me finish. Just now you stated that you was living with your friends in the flat where was ladies. So I am not there. I'm not with you. So why you did not call at that moment?
Do you think they will care for me for that?
So do you?
Because they don't want also to be get involved on this one.
You don't have any family member. You don't have any friends there. You don't have anybody.
And lang. Kaya may mapupulutan po tayo rito, ano, mga kababaihan, ano? This is just for me.
Yes, sir.
This has nothing to do with both of you. Ito yung advice ko sa lahat ng mga kababaihan. Sa oras kayo po'y sinakta ng inyong partner, agad-agad kayo po'y magsumbong sa mga kinukulan. Magpa-medical kayo, picturean nyo, tama itong ginawa niya, and tumawag kayo sa otoridad. Pwede sa barangay, pwede sa polis, ipablatra nyo, parang ebidensya. Kasi sa ngayon, lalabas itong he said, she said. Inaakusahan niya itong si Mr. Muhammad ng pananakit. Sabi ni Mr. Muhammad, hindi ko gagawa niyan, magbanggit ka kung kailan yan, may mga binanggit siyang mga okasyon. So, wala eh, malabo talaga eh. Whereas kung si ma'am sana nagpablatter o nagtawag sa mga otoridad at meron siyang daladalang papeles galing sa otoridad na in fact nagpablatter siya, then mas kapanipaniwala, ma'am. Sa ngayon, it will be a case of she said, he said. Medyo alanganin po ang sitwasyon mo rito kung tutuusin. Nanggigess niyo po, ma'am, hindi sa kinakampiyan ko po siya, ma'am. Kung nakita mo kanina, kinakampiyan din kita. So, tumatawid ako left and dito, no? Kung sino sa tingin ko ang merong punto, pinapanigan ko. So, this time, meron din punto itong si sir, bakit ka kasi hindi tumawag sa numerong yun? Although meron kasi sinabing reason, pero you're a smart girl. Hindi ka basta-basta maging brand ambassadress kung ikaw ay ob-ob. You're smart na you could have done the right thing, which is call the authorities at isuplong mo ito. Now, tapusin na po natin, napakahaba na, sige, pwede tayong lumipat doon. Mag-news break tayo and then let's see kung kaya natin silang pag-ayusin. Of air.
We could not use the name of the other people, but they have already mentioned what was your past. I hope you understand what I mean.
What was your past, sir?
You no need to do this kind of thing. You want
That's
me also
what I
to
want.
Show them also your past, what you're doing?
What is it that you want to show about
you
your past?
You can see it in the...
And I want also show
ahead,
the past.
Go ahead. Hold on. Okay, before you guys can show sensitive documents against each other, let me warn you that once you show it to us, it will be a point of no return. The whole world will see it.